So this is going to be an unpopular opinion, but I believe the one thing that every online business needs is a website. I think that it is non-negotiable, and I really do not promote the idea that you don't need one in order to make money online. I see a lot of make money online gurus talking about you don't need a website, you don't even need money to start, you don't even need a skill, it's so easy. Like, all of these things are just buzzwords to kind of help you feel good, but it's not really the truth. And it really does people a lot of disservice. Now, one thing I do want to just call out is that a lot of these same make money online gurus would be selling you some sort of coaching or course, and guess what? They use a website in order to process payments and run their business, which more times than none is probably hustling you. But they have a website, or they are using some other sort of website where they pay a monthly fee in order to house their video course or whatever the digital product or program that they have that they are trying to sell you on how it is to make money online, according to them, right? So just look into that. If there are any of these types of gurus out there telling you you don't need a website, just look and see if they have one, which is like just an obvious red flag, right? Because the truth is that you cannot have a business function properly online if you do not have the infrastructure set up for the business processes to go to completion. Now, what do I mean by that? For example, like in the real and physical world, right, you would go into like the shopping mall or into one of the main streets in town where there are lots of businesses. These businesses are in buildings, whether it be buildings they own or shops or offices that they are renting within a building or within a shopping center, right? They will have their storefront with the products or the services being advertised so that it entices you to walk into the store. Inside the store, it will have like a sales person that helps facilitate the sale of whoever is the prospective client or customer. Then they will have the cashier who's going to process the payments, and then the transaction is complete. We go from potential customer to paying customer, and then hopefully to satisfied customer based on the results that the product or the service provides, right? Because you need to exchange value in order to get money from people. That's how business works. So in the same way, this is supposed to happen online. So in the virtual sense, right, you should have a virtual store or a digital shop, which would be your website. Then you would need a salesperson, which would be your sales funnel, which either leads to your website and has also one within your website. Meaning to say, when somebody is perusing your website, it should be very, very clear what it is you sell, and it should answer questions that a potential customer would have, and it should be very user-friendly. These are all the things that a salesperson would help do. A sales funnel will also help guide someone who is a potential customer or client towards the sale, and this could be done outside of the website in terms of content marketing on YouTube or in terms of social media advertising as well. email marketing is also a great way to have set up a sales funnel, but all of these things must ultimately lead back to your website, because that is where the transaction will be completed. And on the last leg of that process is, of course, the checkout system, which is like having a cashier. So you need something to facilitate the processing of payments on your website so that you could make the sale and you can now have a paying customer and hopefully a satisfied customer at the end, right? So I don't understand why people don't see that those three things are highly necessary, and the only way that you could have that is with a website. Now, with a website, it could be something that you develop yourself or something that you pay for somebody to develop, or it could be rented out from another platform. So say that you are using FG Funnels, Kajabi, Kartra, there's a plethora of them out there to help you do this. I would name some of the bigger ones, Etsy, Amazon, even though some of these platforms will not work for people from third world countries like myself, which is why I recommend that you develop your own website with WordPress. Why do I say WordPress? Because WordPress is one of the oldest website builders out there, which means that more times than none, there would be software and plugins for third world countries because it's the oldest, which means that's most likely what people are learning on and working with. So for example, it's definitely easier to find a payment processing plugin for your country, from probably any country that works with WooCommerce, that works with the WordPress platform, than Shopify, which is newer. I'm not saying that it won't exist, I'm just saying that most likely it won't. Most likely you'll get a WooCommerce plugin for your country faster than you would get like a Shopify plugin. So probably in the next decade it would be ready, but right now most likely it won't be ready. And if it is, it might be really, really buggy, because remember, these platforms are not very inclusive to small, insignificant third world countries. And when I say insignificant, I mean insignificant to them, right? To the bigger countries. So with all of that being said, I think that a lot of people don't promote this, and those who are aspiring business owners and entrepreneurs kind of don't embrace this ideology either, because they either need to spend time or money when it comes to this website design and development. They don't want to spend time learning how to do it themselves, which for most startups you have to learn and do a lot of things yourselves, because you simply probably don't have the money to hire it out, or you need to find the money to hire it out because you just simply have no desire at all to learn how to do this, which I totally understand and I totally respect. I think I feel that same way about bookkeeping. Yeah, definitely hiring that out the first chance I get, right? So I really, really think that I can help you in both aspects, whether you are in the camp of I don't want to pay anybody, I don't have the money to pay anybody, but I am willing to learn how to develop my own website. You can look at my website and development series here, how I developed the first iteration of my website. And I will leave some information down below of where I learned how to develop websites. But if you're in the camp of people who have no desire at all to learn how to develop and design their own website, I have something special for you as a upcoming business owner and entrepreneur in this online space. I am providing website development services, and it will be on a tiered pricing, which all that means is that if you want a full-on website, which is like minimum 4 pages, right, that's going to be way more. However, I am providing 1-page website development where you could just start off with 1 page that tells a little bit about yourself, showcase your products and services, give a little bit of product reviews or client testimonials, and have a checkout section where they could purchase whatever it is you are selling. And you can check out this service, which will be live on my website. I'll put it as the pinned comment and in the description. So if you're ready to have a thriving online business, let me help you build it one way or another. And I look forward to working with you.